Dave awoke in a somewhat familiar place, feeling dazed and confused, with a pounding headache, feeling like, well, that he'd just been crushed to pieces, actually. Suddenly, a familiar voice spoke to him. Dave! 257, you're here? Wait, what's going on? What's happened? I'm dead, idiot, and so are you, by the looks of it. You mean... Yep, dead, gone, deceased, finite, snuffed out, kaput! Need I go on? No. You know, I always thought I'd go out in some sort of fireball while saving the love of my life. But geez, your way was a damn clone to that impossible. You sacrificed your own life trying to save Hannah. Well done, mate. But what the hell am I going to do? Leanne's going to kill her, isn't she? And now I'm dead, and you're dead. We can't stop her. We... Suddenly, from out of the mist, came an engine Dave had seen once before. The engine that evidently lived here. Well, bend me over and kiss my ass, Pan. Is that... Pogo? I fucking told you I wasn't making him up, you pleb. Sorry, dude. I didn't believe in ghosts, did I? Pogo coughed. Both engines looked apprehensive. You fucking idiots. You messed up everything. What? You two weren't meant to die. Didn't I warn you, Dave? I warned you that some great danger was on the horizon. And you were all too stupid to realise what Leanne had done. Well, it's not like anybody dropped us any hints, is it? It was only this morning I figured it out. Mr. Dark was absolutely genuinely convinced that she was the real Repulse. And besides, I managed to warn Dave, didn't I? But he fucked it up by dying as well. And I did have an inkling, like when she first arrived, but everyone convinced me I'm being paranoid, so... yeah. Well... I guess I have no choice but to send you two back to the beginning of today. Dave, I'll need to wipe your memory, but 257, I need you to try and fix this.
Me? Why me? Dave's the main character.
Because if you had kept your fat mouth shut, this would have not played out this way, and it would have played out more beneficially for the railway, which I have been assigned to protect. Somebody had to die today, and it better not be either of you two this time.
Dave and 257 glanced at each other as their surroundings began to fade away. 257 awoke to find himself stood at the back of the shed again, evidently back at the beginning of that morning. He remembered everything that had just happened, but had no real idea what he was supposed to do to prevent it all happening again. Then he suddenly remembered something. He saw Ed moving trucks around in the yard.
Ed, get your ass over here! Now!
Ed obliged and rolled over looking irritated.
Can I help you? Quick, you've got to get me into the carriage sidings. Like, now?
Why the hell do you...
Look, mate, I don't have time to explain. Just do it.
Begrudgingly, Ed took 257 out of the sheds and out of the way. And as expected by 257, 5 minutes later, Repulse, really Leanne, rolled back towards the sheds, muttering quite audibly, convinced as she was of her solitude. Both Ed and 257 listened hard.
He won't escape me this time. Not this time. Not after Barry Scrapyard when he escaped. Not after Doncaster when they foiled my plan yet again. No, this time I will get my revenge on Dave and his friends. And it will be sweeter than ever.
Ed whispered to 257.
Is she saying what I think she's saying?
Yes, that engine is not the real Repulse. It's Dave's ex, Leanne. And today, the day she snaps.
Leanne? The one he dated in 1960? The one who tried to scrap him, then tried to kill you lot? That's actually plausible, I reckon. And to think I had a cheeky wank over her last week.
Ew.
Ed, you really aren't going to believe this, but I think I died and come back in time or something, because I know she's given out a clue about her real identity right this second, and well, in the alternative timeline, I kinda got myself killed trying to confront her.
Oh, you stupid scrub.
I know. Well, we both know this now. All we have to do is warn Dave. Hopefully she won't go straight to him. Christ, I don't even know if she knows where he is.
The two engines carefully looked on, and as Leanne rolled out toward the main line 20 minutes later, Camma began rolling in.
257 and Ed listened hard as Leanne and Camma made an exchange.
Oh, hi Camma.
Hi Repulse.
You don't happen to have seen Dave this morning, have you?
Oh sure, yeah. You went down to the industrial with Dave for a break with Hannah.
Why? Is he in trouble?
No, not yet anyway.
And she puffed away. As Camma rolled in, Ed, dragging 257, angrily confronted him.
Camma, you twat! Why did you tell her where Dave was?
She asked nicely enough. Why, shouldn't I have?
You wouldn't believe us if we tried to explain.
Go on then.
We haven't got time. We've got to go and stop her from killing Dave and possibly Hannah.
Why would she do that?
Because she's not the real Whipole, she's Leanne.
And you know this, how?
Chuh, Diesels, always asking questions. Fine, don't believe us, but get out of our way before we set fire to you.
Completely in the dark, and feeling that the two engines had gone completely insane, Camma moved aside for them, as Ed struggled to drag 257 out towards the mainline, both trying to prevent a potential disaster.
Meanwhile, at the industrial estate, Leanne had arrived, and having tormented Dave and Hannah by revealing herself to them and by telling them how she had managed to arrive on the line and remain there undetected, was now blocking their escape route whilst revealing her true motive.
I really only wanted to be happy, you know. But seeing you happy with someone else, Dave, I couldn't allow that. And now, it's time for me to finally put an end to your life. But first I shall kill your beautiful little girlfriend, so that you can see what true pain and suffering feels like.
Leanne was about to move forward, when from the yard entrance, Ed, with 257 in tow, charged in straight at Leanne.
What the?
Ed smashed into her, knocking her backwards into a siding, clearing Dave and Hannah's path.
Ed, 257, what the hell? Quick, no time to explain, come with us, now!
Ed reversed as quickly as he could with 257 ahead of him, as Hannah and Dave charged after them. But Leanne hadn't been fully immobilised, and she furiously charged after them. Through the tunnel they charged, with Leanne beginning to catch up to them.
I'll get you, Dave! I swear I'll exact my revenge! Not even death can stop me!
But evidently it could. For as the four engines screamed out of the tunnel, Leanne's front bogey wheel derailed just near the top. Jeez, that bad track in the tunnel really doesn't like Sally or bogies at speed, does it? The engine stopped outside as, horrified, they watched the gas-powered tunnel began to disintegrate due to the impact on the tunnel wall, with Leanne trapped inside. With a loud cry, Leanne screamed her last ever scream in this life, as the entire tunnel collapsed in upon itself, with the structures above it, the gasworks and the housing estate on the other side, collapsed in and sank as a fire started. The haunting echoes of Leanne's final scream echoed all around. As this had happened, an engine briefly appeared outside the tunnel. 257 recognised it, and so did Dave. Pogo stood watching the entire area crash and crumble in upon itself. Then he disappeared, his work evidently done. Badly shaken, Dave looked back towards the tunnel.
Oh. Well, she's... she's...
Yep! Dead, gone, deceased, finit, stuffed out, kaput.
After everything she put you through, Dave, after everything she put all of us through, I don't think she would really have ever changed. There is nothing you could do.
It's probably for the best that she's dead, mate. I'll have to find someone new to have a wank over, mind. You're all right. Except you, Ed. Do you have no shame? But it's still horrific to see. But she was going to kill us all anyway, so... well, that's a win in my book.
Come on, guys. We'd better get out of here. That fire's getting really intense. We'd better see if anyone's informed the emergency services. Come on, Dave. Let's go home.
Dave took one final look at the tunnel, grimaced, then proceeded back up the good branch with Hannah, Ed and 257. Knowing that, at least, Leanne would never, ever try to hurt him or his friends again. 257 looked back once more, feeling good about himself. He wasn't dead, Dave wasn't dead, and the evil bitch was. Grinning to himself, he allowed himself to be swept up the branch with the combined help of his good friends.
Crying 257, lose a couple of pounds, will you?
You really are fat, 257.
Fat bastard, shut up!
Well, despite the fact that our heroes were still alive, and that they were all feeling relieved to be alive,
they now had to face the consequences of what had just happened. The emergency services were quickly called to the scene of the collapse, but they couldn't extinguish the fire until early next morning, when the damage could be clearly seen. Everything above and around the tunnel had been destroyed and burned to ashes, and worse, according to the local news stations, many lives had been lost that afternoon, with hundreds of deaths being reported due to fire, suffocation and being crushed. And of course, they mentioned the burnt, wrecked, melted, crushed remains of a steam locomotive buried within the mess. Mr. Dark had a lot to answer for after this, as investigators determined that poor track and tunnel maintenance had been the cause of the entire incident. He took full responsibility for the accident, and was ordered to pay out the countless amounts of compensation to all the families who lost loved ones in the collapse and subsequent fire, as well as financing the relocation of the victims and their families. Once it had been established that the engine that had been destroyed was indeed Leanne, Mr. Dark began making inquiries into the location of the real Repulse, for he still intended her to come and work on the line, even after all of this mess. She was discovered at Horton by a friendly mainline diesel, who brought her up to the railway for real this time. The true Repulse was, understandably, freaked out, terrified and nervous when she arrived, and immediately broke down in front of Mr. Dark, who wanted to know the full story. "I know you must be distressed, Repulse, but I want to know what happened before we found you."
"Well, I left Mr. Smash's scrapyard on the Friday night. We were making good time, but on Saturday morning we were intercepted by her. She killed my escort, blocked the line, then took that place. She tortured me for information about myself for 2 days before taking my nameplate and numbers and knocking me out. She left me there, but came back sometimes to beat me for information. She broke my bogey wheel, sir, and took my tender away from me. I couldn't get help, so I could get here and stop her."
She began to cry, and Mr. Dark comforted her. "It's not your fault, Repulse. You know that."
Yes, sir."
"And you're truly safe now, all right?"
"But what about her? Is she here? She escaped, didn't she? She's going to come back and finish me."
No, she won't, Repulse. She died a few weeks ago. In a tunnel collapse, actually. So she won't be back to attack you again."
Okay, sir."
"I'll have to sideline you until I can get someone to look at your wheels, though. You are all right with that?"
Yes, sir."
Mr. Dark left her to recuperate in the sheds, sighing as he walked away. When the real Repulse arrived at Mirkoomb, the engines were, understandably, very weary of her. Unfortunately, Repulse was a nervous wreck because of her experience with Leanne, and found it incredibly difficult to trust anybody, often breaking down into tears if somebody came near her, or freaking out if somebody spoke to her. Dave and Hannah watched from afar, and together concluded that this engine had been affected by Leanne just as much as they had. They resolved to keep an eye on her, and to keep their distance, just in case.